Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about inverse Laplace transforms. And in this particular problem, we've been given the function f of s equals s plus 3 divided by s squared plus 4s plus 13. And I made a little typo here. I accidentally put x, so I've just written over it and drawn in an s. But this function here has already been put through the Laplace transform process. And what we've been asked to do in this problem is reverse that process and find the original function that we must have put through the Laplace transform process to get here to f of s. So the way that we're going to do that is using these two formulas here for e to the at cosine of bt and e to the at sine of bt. The reason that we're going to be using those formulas, I got these formulas from an inverse Laplace transform table. You'll use them fairly commonly in inverse Laplace transforms just because you'll oftentimes have this e to the at and sine and cosine, of course, will commonly occur with all these kinds of problems. So you may not know right off the bat that these are the formulas you need to use, but what you should recognize is that in the numerator here you have s plus 3, which you can also write as s minus negative 3, which is kind of similar to what we've got here, s minus a, right? A is a constant, b is a constant in both of these formulas. And then in the denominator, you have s squared plus 4s plus 13, which is a polynomial. And if you see over here with this formula, we've got two squareds. We've got the quantity s minus a squared, and we have b squared. We know that with this denominator over here, if we use the method of completing the square, we might be able to pull out a squared term from this. So this formula here for e to the at times cosine of bt could be promising, but we may not know that originally. So we're just going to try to complete the square in the numerator and see how this goes. So remember that with completing the square, when you've got a polynomial like this, s squared plus 4s plus 13, to complete the square, you're going to be looking at this coefficient here on the s to the first power term. Remember that you have to get the sign. If that was minus 4s, you would need to get the negative sign too. But you've got this positive 4. You're going to take that number and you're going to divide it by 2. And remember, this is the method for completing the square. So you divide it by 2, and of course you get 2. Whatever you get for your answer, you're going to square it. And of course, 2 squared gives you 4. So 4 is what you're going to add to this polynomial in order to complete the square. So what we're going to have now is f of s equals s plus 3, and then in the denominator we'll pair these together. So we're gonna, the 4 that we're gonna add is gonna complete the square with s squared and 4s. So we'll have s squared plus 4s plus 4, and then we've got plus 13 outside here. Because we added 4 to the denominator, we also need to subtract 4, right? Because if we just add 4, that fundamentally changes the function. So now that we have plus 4 and minus 4, it's like we haven't even changed the function at all. We're just manipulating it in a way that'll make it more convenient to work with. So now we've got s plus 3 in the numerator, and in the denominator, we can call this s plus 2 squared, right? If we factor that s squared plus 4s plus 4, we would get s plus 2 times s plus 2, which gives us s plus 2 squared. Then here on the right-hand side, this plus 13 minus 4 gives us a plus 9. So we're starting to see this look more and more like our formula here for e to the at times cosine of bt. You can see, though, in the denominator, this s minus a squared, we need that to be a negative sign. So instead of s plus 2, we're going to make it s minus negative 2, right? Which also doesn't change fundamentally the function, because we have minus a negative 2, which is the same thing as s plus 2, but at least we've got that negative 2 now. So we've got minus negative 2, and then notice here we need a b squared, right? Well, we have plus 9, so we know that we can change that into 3 squared, right? So now our denominator looks very similar to the denominator of our formula. And we just need to change the numerator, because notice this s minus a here needs to match this s minus a in the denominator. So in order to do that, we need that to be s minus negative 2 in the numerator. The way we're going to do it is we're going to say s minus a negative 2 right? What we essentially have done here is we've added 2, right? Because this is the same as s plus 2. So since we've added 2, we're also going to subtract 2, and of course we have to leave in that plus 3. So when we do that, and we have in the denominator here s minus negative 2 plus 3 squared. So when we do that, we'll have this s minus negative 2. And now we've got here minus 2 and plus 3. So that's going to turn into plus 1. So we'll write this up here. F of s equals s minus negative 2. And then we get plus 1 all over s minus negative 2 plus 3 squared. So now our function looks exactly the same as our formula here for e to the at times cosine of bt. The only thing that we need to deal with here is that what I've boxed here in orange matches our formula exactly, except for this plus 1, right? We need to get that out of there because that is not included here in our formula. We don't have like another plus b or plus c, you know, some other constant to account for that plus 1. So we got to get it out. So what we're going to end up doing is splitting our fraction. So we'll end up with s minus a negative 2 all over s minus negative 2. Oh, and I'm sorry, along here I lost my squared. This is squared, squared, and squared, plus 3 squared. And that plus 1, we're going to break out into a separate fraction. So we'll have plus 1 over the same denominator. So squared plus 3 squared. So now this is where our second formula comes into play. This e to the at times sine of bt. Notice that we've got the same s minus a squared, right, which we've already taken care of. We have the b squared, which we've already taken care of, right? The denominator is the same. The only thing that's different is we have this b term here in our numerator. And obviously this b variable here has to match this b variable, right? They're the same. So we know that in our denominator here, we've got b equal to 3, which means we need to get our numerator equal to 3. And the way we're going to do that is by multiplying this by 3 over 3. So when we do that, we'll leave the first fraction the same, s minus negative 2 divided by s minus negative 2 squared plus 3 squared. But the second term here, we want the 3 here to stay in the fraction, and this 1 over 3 here, right, 1 in the numerator, 3 in the denominator, we're going to move that out in front. So we'll do plus 1/3 times 3, right? This 3 right here is what's staying in the numerator. So 3 divided by s to the negative 2 squared plus 3 squared. So now this part here is exactly in the exact same form as our formula here, right? And our first fraction, this one, is in the exact same form as this formula, the formula for e to the at times cosine of bt. So now that we have these things in the same format, we can do the inverse Laplace transform to find the function f of t. So we'll say that f of t is going to be equal to, we just need to identify here a and b. So we can see from our first fraction that a is equal to negative 2, right? We see it here, and we see it here, negative 2, and we know that b is equal to 3, right? B equals 3, which we see here. In our second fraction, we have, don't forget about the 1/3 here, we'll get to that in a second, but we have, same thing, a equals negative 2, which we get from this part right here, and we have b equals 3, same thing, which we see b right here and b right here. So now we can go ahead and use our formulas. So for our teal fraction here, we'll use the formula e to the at times cosine of bt. So we'll get e, our a is negative 2, so we'll get negative 2t times cosine. We know that b is equal to 3, so times cosine of 3t. Then, remember, don't forget about the 1/3 here. We got to make sure we have that. So we'll do 1/3 times, we'll use our green formula, this one up here, e to the at times sine of bt. So we'll get e, again, a is negative 2, so e to the negative 2 t times sine of bt. We know b is equal to 3, so we get sine of 3t. And that's it. That's our final answer. This is the answer we get when we do the inverse Laplace transform on our original function, capital F of s. This is f of t, our original function, that if we now performed a Laplace transform on f of t, we would wind up back at capital F of s. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.